closure. I'm older and I'm moving faster than ever. I'm cold with it, weather for caster. So whether it's four lines or more, I'm the master of never.
Cinema posted talk.
You talk normal. Just because you hear yourself doesn't mean you have to talk differently.
I don't know how.
Just say something normal.
Something normal?
Okay, but say it not that slow. Okay. What's up, guys? It's
How
Pastor Jordan.
Else talk?
What's up, guys? It's Pastor Jordan. Today I'm here with my girlfriend, Valeria, again.
Hi.
For some more X. This time we're doing XXX Tentacion Before I Close My Eyes. I have a lyric video pulled up just because it's easier to hear everything and to know what he's saying, especially because he likes to do so much distortion with his voice. So we're just going to start. Do you remember last time? Do you watch my videos? You know who
yes.
he is?
Yes.
Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Do you remember how he died? Okay, somebody shot him. He was shot and killed.
Why?
They wanted to take money from him. Some people think it's like a lot deeper. They have like tons of conspiracies and stuff. But the news says that he had money in his car. They shot him and killed him and took the money. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So here we go.
Pour me down to sleep. Lord, my soul to king. Hope's not too light for me.
Did you ever pray that prayer?
Mm-hmm.
With who? By yourself?
Yeah.
Or like at church? Or like at nighttime and like in front of your bed?
At nighttime, yeah.
My grandma used to pray it, but the song is like, or the prayer's like, so the end of it says, if I die, if I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. And then he says, he doesn't say if I die before I wake. He just says, after the first part, he says, I hope it's not too late for me. But I always feel like, I don't know, I just feel like this prayer is a little weird too, because it's literally like, if I die. And he liked to talk about his death a lot. So I feel like that's what he's like hinting at. Probably after this line, he'll say something about it. That's my guess. You think it's sad?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know.
Does it sound sad?
Yes.
To sleep, pray Lord my soul to king. Hope's not too light for me. Pour me down to sleep, pray Lord my soul to keep. Hope's not too late for me. Changing in the distance, time consumes the image. Difference, changing in the distance, time consumes our image.
Do you have any thoughts?
Yeah.
Well, what are they?
This is not the only song he has about his death.
No, there's tons.
But why does he like to talk about that?
I don't know. A lot of people feel like he really thought that he was gonna die, like soon, and so he would always talk about it. And I say, like, with the other artist, Juice WRLD, it was kind of like, it wasn't surprising that he would always talk about his death because he was living a life that was going to lead to death. But for him, like he was murdered. It wasn't like he overdosed or like he was, you know, living a crazy life. It literally just happened by chance. But he really talked about like dying more than Juice WRLD even. Like he literally would say, like, there's tons and tons of songs where he says, like, I think I'm gonna die, this is gonna happen, I'm gonna die. And he constantly says things like here where he says, I hope it's not too late for me. Like he constantly like I think he was wrestling like with where his soul was gonna go or what was gonna happen to him after his death. I think that he was like really, really concerned with his life and like how it would end and like where he would go or how that would happen.
And I think even saying that, like, I hope it's not too late for me, like, even if you're not thinking you're going to die soon, like, that's a thought I constantly have.
How?
Like, you always think, like, I hope I'm good. Like, does that make sense?
Tell me more.
Like, you get worried about what's going to happen to you after you die. I think even if you think you're, like, the holiest person on the planet, like, you never know, you know? We're not God. So I always just think, like, I hope I'm, like, good. Like, if I die tonight, like, am I good or, like, what's gonna happen? So I understand that, like, what he's saying.
I always say if I'm judged based off of whether I'm good or not, like, I'm like, like I'm going straight down. But I don't think it's about whether or not I'm good. I think it's about whether or not I trust Jesus to be like my sacrifice. Because I'm not good. I'm terrible. I'm a really bad person inside. But most people are. Everybody has something that's bad in them. And the bad always outweighs the good. You can never do enough good things to outweigh the bad. What are you saying?
Okay.
Oh, okay. You're really distracting me.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Okay. You can't do enough good things to outweigh the bad. And so everybody is deserving of not being with God. But God sent his son to die for us so that we don't have to worry about it. It's like a debt that you can't pay. Like you don't have enough money to pay no matter how rich you are. It doesn't matter how rich you are on this earth. You can't pay that debt. But Jesus paid it for you. So you don't have to pay it. And the debt never comes back. It's paid. It's done. But even then, you wonder if you really like had it right. You wonder if you really trusted or if Jesus is going to be like, nah, I never knew you. That's in the Bible. It says that there's a lot of people who think they're going to be saved. And they're like, oh, yeah, I'm up there for sure. I'm so sure. And then they get up there and Jesus is like, I never knew you. Go away from me. That's what the Bible talks about. But the Bible says, ask yourself whether or not you're in the faith to be sure and approved. So this question, even for mature Christians, even for pastors, even for like the holiest of people, is a question that you should ask yourself. And when you ask yourself, if you're not sure, you should try to be more sure. It should prompt you to take time to think about these things. Like whether or not X was a Christian or whether or not he believed in Jesus, like I know that you guys tell me he didn't, he believed in other spiritual things or whatever. I'm still trying to figure out what that means. But if there is something after your death and it's eternal, it matters more than what you do here. So you should take time to think about it. It should matter to you. Literally, you'll sit down for 2 or 3 hours at a bank and talk about your finances, or you'll sit down for 2 or 3 hours and talk about this or that. You know, you'll go to school for 8 hours a day to learn how to do a certain skill, but you can't take any time to think about what you're going to, what you're doing with your life, what you're doing with your soul, how you're living your life, how that matters on a scale of eternity. And I feel like people should take more time to think about that. I know that X did, regardless of whether or not we would disagree on where you go or what happens. I know that he took a lot of time to think about those things. And at least his viewpoint came from himself, and he's not just saying, like, oh, I just believe what other people tell me. I think that you should come to conclusions yourself. So we might disagree on the conclusion, but at least you're not preaching what other people tell you. Nothing? Hmm? Alright, let's move on. Oh, one more thing. Sorry. He said, in this part, he said, time consumes the image. And then over here he says, where is it? Time consumes our image. I love when songs do this, and I think it's on purpose. There's a song that I love, and it says, it talks about, like, this is, and then eventually it says you are. And here he says, time consumes the image, and then he finally says, time consumes our image. And I feel like he's getting to the point that he's talking about death, he's talking about aging, he's talking about, you know, life just continuing on. And we're not promised tomorrow, we're not promised another day, we're not promised time. Everybody's getting older, things move on, things happen. Like, I always think about, you know, in the movies, if somebody dies, it's like rainy outside. That's not real life. It could be the most shiniest, beautiful day, and somebody's dead. And it's because time just moves on. Time just happens. And that's another reason for you to be thinking about your eternal life. It's another reason for you to be thinking about what you're doing with your life and the choices you're making. And if you die today and you look back at your life, are you going to be happy with what you left? Time consumes our image. It doesn't just consume the image. When some of us are going to die and it's going to be sunny outside. And you have to really think about that. I don't know if that makes sense. Does that make sense?
Yes.
For lay me down to sleep, pray the Lord my soul to keep, hope's not too late for me. Lord, lay me down to sleep, pray the Lord my soul to keep, hope's not too late for me.
What are your thoughts?
When you were talking about how people should really just think about, like, how they're living their life and stuff, I also feel like deep down, people do care about this, whether they believe in God or whether they believe in whatever, what happened to them when they die. I do think people think about this a lot, but I think people tend to just say, well, I'm still young, I'll worry about it later when I have to. When reality is, you never know when you're going to die. You know, so I feel like that's why a lot of people, maybe it's an excuse, like.
I feel like it's because it's uncomfortable to think about.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like you don't want to have to, like, I even think that for some people it may be like, well, it's going to be boring if I'm just good, or if I, like, do certain things, so I'll worry about it later, just because they don't want to have to, like, think about it, or.
Yeah, I feel like if you're thinking about your death, you have to look yourself, like, in a very clear mirror and see who you really are. But I also find a lot of people who, like, because I feel like there's people like that who take the idea of death and they just kind of push it away. They don't want to think about it. And then I feel like there's people who just hide behind something. And so they'll just say, oh, I believe what this person believes, or, oh, I just believe this. And they don't really believe it. They just say what other people say. Like, if you build your entire belief system based off of what somebody else believes, it's not going to work. Even if you're a Christian, God doesn't have grandchildren. God only has sons and daughters. Meaning, just because your grandma or your mom is a real good Christian doesn't mean that God knows you. You have to know God yourself. I think that you should take the time to figure out what you believe, and you should build it based off of your own relationship with God. And I still think that Jesus is the only truth and the life and the way. But I think that people have to come to that conclusion themselves. And if they don't, it's not real. I hope that makes sense. But I just don't like when people say that they believe something. I have cousins or, like, people that I talk to, and I'm like, why are you an atheist? Why do you believe that? Oh, I don't know. Like, if you don't know, don't say you are, because you don't really know what you are. That frustrates me. But I tend to talk about the reality of death a lot, and I don't shy away from it, because I think that it's very important. And because if I died today, I would be happy. I would be happy with what I left.
I think that's also, like, a very deep thought. Like, if I died today, will I be happy? Because I feel like, you know, a thing, not a thing now, but just you know, you see it in, like, even teenagers a lot, how they're just depressed all the time. And
yeah.
It's hard to think about the fact that if I die, will I be happy with what I did?
Yeah.
You know? Like, that's hard to think about.
Yeah. Good song. I liked it. Make sure you add me on Discord. Go follow my second channel. I'm almost to 1,000 subscribers. Follow me on Instagram. I'm almost to 2,000 followers. We're blowing up, man. We're doing really good. Remember, I react to your music on Saturdays. It's been really, really awesome. You guys are extremely talented. I really look forward to it. That's it. I'll see you guys in the next video.
I had a bad day. 11 years I dealt with that the same way. Emotions spiraling, a pilot screaming, mayday, mayday. Porn screaming, make way. Make room in your life, I'll be your Potiphar's wife. I'll ease your pain and your strife, I'll be your reason to lie. So you can eat with your eyes, make love with me in your mind. I've been looking for you, I just wanted to help you. I know you're struggling right now, it's been a while since I felt you. I know just a thing to ease the strain, that it overwhelm you. Just forget about your problems with the way that I touch you. I know you think about it,